Hello everyone, I'm back with another integral. It contains current year 2023. Before I start my solution, if you're new to my channel, please subscribe to it. So if you look at this term x to the power 2023 plus 1, we want to get rid of this term. And if you look at this term x plus 1 over root 2x and consider it as fx and try to find f of 1 over x that is same as fx, we'll use this fact later. But first substitute x equal to 1 over t, then we get dx equal to minus 1 over t square dt, and I equal to our limit changes from infinity to 0, and f of 1 over t is same as ft, so we can simply write it as ft, and this term will become t to the power 2023 over t to the power 2023 plus 1 into, and this term will become t square over 1 plus t square, and dx will become minus 1 over t square dt. So we can cancel t square, we take this minus sign and now change our limit, I equal to 0 to infinity. Change in variable doesn't affect the value of definite integral, so we can simply write in term of x fx into x to the power 2023 over x to the power 2023 plus 1 into 1 over 1 plus x square dx. Consider it as second equation and this one as first equation, and if we add both of them we get 2y equal to 0 to infinity. This term fx 1 over 1 plus x square is common in both, so we take common fx 1 plus x square, and first we have 1 over x to the power 2023 plus 1 plus, in second we have x to the power 2023 over 1 plus x to the power 2023, and this dx, this whole term is equal to 1, so we are left with 2y equal to integration 0 to infinity fx 1 plus x square dx. Now we are going to substitute x equal to tan theta, we get dx equal to sec square theta d theta, so our limit become 2y equal to limit changes from 0 to pi by 2 f of tan theta 1 plus tan square theta into sec square theta d theta. We can cancel 1 plus tan square theta sec square theta, overall we get 2y equal to 0 to pi by 2 f of tan theta. Reduce our original integral to this. Now we are going to convert everything in terms of sine and cos. So 1 plus sine theta over cos theta root over 2 sine theta over cos theta d theta 0 to pi by 2, this is equal to 2i. If you simplify this whole term, we will get sine theta plus cos theta over root under 2 sine theta into cos theta d theta. This is 0 to pi by 2. 2y equal to. Now we are going to express this term in terms of sine theta minus cos theta. So you know this sine theta minus cos theta whole square equal to sine square theta plus cos square theta, 1 minus 2 sine theta into cos theta. Okay, so we will simply replace 2 sine theta cos theta from this equation. This is sine theta plus cos theta, it will become root under, this will become 1 minus sine theta minus cos theta whole square and d theta, this is 2i. Okay, if you look at this term, if you substitute this equal to t, then this into d theta will become dt, so that is same as 1 over root under 1 minus t square dt. This is antiderivative of sine inverse t, so we can simply write it as 2i equal to sine inverse of sine theta minus cos theta, and our limit is 0 pi by 2. Okay, now we are going to substitute the limit. Sin inverse of sine pi by 2 1, cos pi by 2 0. Sin inverse of sine 0 0, cos 0 1, that is minus 1 here. And this is pi by 2. And this is minus pi by 2. So overall, we'll get pi 2i equal to pi, I equal to pi by 2. We get the nice answer pi by 2. So that's it. That's how you solve it. If you like my video, please subscribe to my channel. If you have another idea, another solution, please post it in comment. See you in next video with another problem. Bye.